Good afternoon, and welcome to St. Rosalie's in Hampton East. Today we celebrate the 14th Sunday in Ordinary Time. We welcome Father Maddaloni as our priest celebrant.
Amen.
Rejoice heartily, O daughter of Zion. Shout for joy, O daughter of Jerusalem. See, your king shall come to you. A just Savior is he, meek and riding on an ass, on a colt, foal of an ass. He shall banish the chariot of Ephraim and the horse from Jerusalem. The warrior's bow shall be banished, and he shall proclaim peace to the nations. His dominion shall be from sea to sea, and from the river to the ends of the earth. The word of the Lord.
Oh, Gospel.
Praise to you, Lord.
I remember one day I was driving, I think I was on Open State Park, it was a big highway, and I was driving along and my windshield was a little dirty. And so I put on those lighters, those washy things, and I squared the windshield, and there was a guy who was driving a little close to me behind. All of a sudden he darts into the next lane, shoots ahead of me, gets in front of me, and puts on his splashers, and splashes my windshield. I guess I got away. But again, he represents a certain attitude. Nobody is going to get one over on me. No one's going to treat me in a way I don't like. Because I am the top and I'm not going to take it. So you picture this guy, picture this attitude, and then contrast that with the readings today. The readings, the first reading of the gospel reading, talk about meekness, being meek. Who wants to be meek? So nobody raises a hand, right? It's not an adjective that sounds particularly attractive to us. But if you hear that first reading, he is meek and riding on an ass. And then it goes on to talk about him. He will banish the chariot, the horse, the warrior's bow, and he shall proclaim peace to the nations. His dominions shall be to the ends of the earth. Does that sound meek to you? Is that our concept of meek? And in the gospel, Jesus says that I am meek. You say, really, this Jesus is meek? Isn't he the one that drove the money changers out of the temple? That stood up to Pharisees, and they refused to back down from what was right? These are not what we think of as meek, but maybe we're thinking about meekness in the wrong way. What does it mean to be meek? Well, I think clearly from these two examples, here's what it does not mean. It does not mean to be cowardly. It does not mean to be a doormat. I would say that to be meek here means to be the opposite of arrogance. Someone who's arrogant says, I know all, I can do all, and I am the top, and you better remember that. Meekness involves, Betty, you're not going to like it, meekness involves submission. Meekness involves submission. My friend on the highway would bristle at that idea. And maybe we do too. Because submission is also not a word that we like, but it's not a dirty word. In fact, we have freedom to choose to what we submit, and we all submit to something. We all do. To what do we submit? Well, sometimes we submit to pride, to greed, to our urges, and we let those feelings have mastery over us. Our masters, and we are the slave to these driving forces. Or do we submit to something much greater than ourselves? Something much better, something much higher. In that sense, Jesus was meek. Because he submits in his human condition, he submits always to the Father's will and subordinates his own human interests to what God calls him to do. And in the process, he submits to abuse, indignity, and death. And he turns around here and challenges us to be meek, too. He says to his father, Father, you have hidden these things from the wise and the learned. You have revealed them to little ones. Now, there's nothing wrong with being wise and learned, of course, right? Unless it leads to arrogance. He asks us, rather, to be like the little ones, like children. Open to the truth, obedient to the will of God, and to submit to our faith, to God, and to the values that Jesus himself. self-talk. It's not easy, because we're tempted. The question is, to what will we submit? And those other urges to submit to anger and pride are around us all the time. They're at school, they're in the community, they're on the highway, obviously. We want to boost ourselves up above Christ's values of love, kindness, forgiveness, faith, and appropriate submission. To submit to something greater than ourselves is not easy, and we cannot do it on our own. We can't. To do it, we need God's grace and the courage to ask for that grace. A prayer for us, I think, in our quest to be meek, is to pray for the courage and the strength to be meek. It's the 4th of July, and we celebrate freedom. And sometimes there's a question of what freedom really means, and sometimes people say, well, freedom means to do what I want. But I say, that freedom really means the freedom to be the best that we can be. There's a big difference between those two. Freedom is the freedom, true freedom, to be the best that we can be. So today, we pray for the courage to be meek and to be free. Together now we profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things are made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended to heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken with the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and life forever. With humble hearts, we come before God to speak for our needs and those of the world.
Our response today is hear our prayer. For the members of the church, may be filled with the Spirit and recommit themselves as good stewards. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
For the leaders and people of this great country, that they provide adequate care for those injured in its service. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
For the men and women of our armed forces, that God keep them healthy and safe. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
For Mary Alice Schur, for whom this Mass is offered, and for all those named in our book of remembrance. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
For the sick of our parish community,
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for when your children were scattered afar by sin, through the blood of your Son and the power of the Spirit, you gathered them again to yourself, that people, formed as one by the unity of the Trinity, made the body of Christ and the temple of the Holy Spirit, might to the praise of your manifold wisdom be manifest as the Church. And so in company with the choirs of angels we praise you, and with joy we proclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna.
Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. Lamb of God. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that having been replenished by such great gifts, we may gain the prize of salvation and never cease to praise you. Through Christ.
Amen.
We have launched our new website. Rosalie.com, you'll see that it looks a little bit different. That's been in the works for a while. I was told the old website looked old-fashioned, what do I know? So the new one apparently looks new-fashioned. So I hear it's very beautiful. I've seen it, it looks beautiful. So check it out when you get a chance. Of course, keep checking it out for updates about what's happening here, because things do change. We are, as you know, we are still broadcasting into the parking lot, but we have not gotten that doesn't seem to be very popular with many people, so just a few people. What we may do in the near future is condense the number of masses that we broadcast into the parking lot app. You shouldn't end with a preposition, but that's the idea. So that will change, that will probably change soon, but not next weekend. So next weekend we will continue to broadcast to all the masses in the parking lot as we've been doing, but that will likely change after that to one mass. I want to wish all of you a good 4th of July weekend. It's a beautiful hot summer weekend, just the kind that I love. As you know,
You can certainly leave. If you stay to receive communion, just for those of you who are doing this now for the first time, you'll come up, the ushers will direct you up one pew at a time, and then you'll kind of go around and go back. When you come up with your mask on and take your mask off to receive communion in the hand, if you want to receive on the tongue, you are permitted to do that, but please wait until the end and then kneel at the kneeler and you can receive on the tongue. So keep the mask up as you come up and then remove it when you receive. Okay?
The Lord be with you.